Hello guys, welcome once again. So today we will be learning how we can implement the screenshot functionality while doing a protected testing. You have learned in Selenium that screenshot is one of the most valid proof for the bugs we used to find, and we can take this screenshot while using the automation testing in an automated way even, and also at the time of creation of this bug. This helps us to identify what was the exact error and where this error occurs. For doing so, Selenium has a lot of features. So we will be learning today how we can implement the features in Protector. As Protector runs on Node.js, so the first thing is that we need to go to console. And when we are in the console, we have to pass a command. The command is npm install protector take screenshots on demand. On passing this command, the Node.js will install the npm package, which will be helpful while integrating the screenshot functionality in Protector. So let's begin with the npm install. This is done. The npm installation is done. We can even check it here. This folder is present. See, protector take screenshots on demand. This is what we are downloading. Protector take screenshots on demand. So it downloaded all the packages and libraries, whatever it needed. So let's start with the configurational changes. We have to do a configurational changes. I have already done this configurational changes for you. Just I am going through what changes I have done. The first thing is that I have created a variable named screenshots, and in that I have used the require functionality, which means it is telling this piece of code requires this library. So this screenshots, we are using screenshots, and now we are giving this name, see, screenshot.screenshot directory. That means where we are going to put it. We are going to put it under target under screenshot. So if you go to my code, you can see that there's a target folder present, and inside the target folder there is screenshots folder presence, right? So once this has been created because I have ran this program once, that's why this folder has been created. If this folder is not present, say I deleted the screenshots folder and make it blank, then at the time of the execution it will automatically create the screenshots folder and it will pass the values. Now create the folder for the screenshot. This is where we are using the create folder. So let's begin the testing. So this is the file which I used to demonstrate this global QA, and it is logging in. And after logging in, I want a screenshot. Say this is for using this, we have to only do this one, screenshots dot take screenshot, and we have to pass the name of the screenshot. We can give a valid name, say login test. SC stands for screenshot. Fine. Now before doing that, we have to also create a variable here, screenshots, and also give the same line, require protector take screenshots on demand. Okay, and then only we can use this screenshot variable here, and screenshot take screenshot. Again, say I want to take screenshot after clicking on the login button, we can do that. So wherever we necessary, we can call this line screenshot.takeScreenshot, and it will keep on taking the screenshots whenever this line will get executed. So without wasting much of our time, let's start this program. Let's say protector conf.js. Fine. So it will instantiate and will run this program, and it will keep on taking the screenshot at the intervals we have mentioned. So this is why this is called screenshot on demand. It is not whenever it is failure or at the end of the test cases. It's not like that. We can use it wherever we want. The execution is going on, and it is also taking the screenshot at the time of the interval we have mentioned at the line of the coding. It has completed, and let's see whether the screenshot folder has been created or not. First, we have to check whether the screenshot folder has been created or not. Yes, the folder screenshot has been created. Once we click on that, see the name Chrome login test underscore SC. So this has been also taken the screenshot. So three screenshot has been taken and the name has been assigned according to the variables we pass. See the name, this is the name we have given there, login test underscore SC. So it has given the login test underscore SC. So we can provide the meaningful name and keep on going execution.